Oddly enough, on my seventh solo album, I feel like I approached it more like my very first album than any other record I've made. I had taken the first long stretch I've ever had off in my entire career. Since I was 17, I've never taken more than 3 months off the road. But finally, you start to realize like how much you need to take a breath. And it does give room for so much more creativity if you're in the studio when you're not coming in off the road just exhausted. I feel like half of the record was probably written before I had the time off, and then the half of it was written when I had the time off. But I like that because it's also part of the journey of kind of the tail end of a phase of life, going into a whole new phase of life. So I feel like I sort of got all that in there by taking a little bit of time.
Around Christmas, she was like, hey, I want to get together, I want to talk about the next record. And she's like, I'm ready to amp it back up.
I think that Miranda this time definitely wanted to make a record that reflected how she was feeling, which was happy and smooth, and like, it's got some sexy, you know, slankiness to it.
Every line gets you somewhere, brings you somewhere, or emotionally takes you somewhere.
She is such an amazing writer. Yeah. She's always on.
I think she's always got a song going in her head.
So I started spending time in New York, and it's really a place that opened your eyes to all the things. You can stumble into a dive bar with a great rock band on accident, you know, and whether I wanted it to or not, the art of the city and the music in the city sort of leaked into my creative process.
The unhappy hour. Bitters and sours, where nobody knows me, where I can be lonely. I'm not in pain, I'm not on pills, but I'm still hanging out in dark bars. But I know a thing or two about broke hearts.
Country is what I do, it's who I am, it's literally just seeps out of my pores. I'm from East Texas, I can't change my accent, and no matter what I sing, it's country music. But I love rock and roll. Blending those two is sometimes tricky because you never know if it's gonna actually gel. But if anyone could, Jay could.
I don't really like the traditional studio where there's a piece of glass in between you and the people and everybody's in their little rooms, and it just takes forever to be spontaneous. So I like working like this. I mean, Miranda's literally right there singing while we're all playing. So you can say, hey, try that chord, you know, and things just move along.
So it's just like me looking at Jay and him going, okay, sing now. Because we just, it was right whenever it felt good, you know?
Got a pretty new truck, got some pretty good look, and some pretty red wine I'm sipping. Got a pretty guitar with a white pick guard and a pretty good song if you listen. It's pretty bitchin'.
What you were saying to me was, I don't want to be so serious for a minute. You know, I want to just get back to rocking out and having fun.
From all the records I've made, I feel like it's the one that I've overthought the least. I just had confidence in the process. I had confidence in him.
Yeah,
I had confidence in the band. I had confidence in the songs. And I was like, I'm not going to go home and like stress myself out to death over this because I don't know. I just felt like it was going to work. At some point, and you make a bunch of records, you get to a place where you're like, what can I do that's going to push me?
I mean, I love the idea because there was an intention behind it. You know, it was like, get more of a spontaneous live thing going.
I didn't really give direction or anything. I just kind of told Jay, like, I've got songs. I'm not going to say these are the songs because I'm not sure what the songs are until we go in. Because I wanted the band and the feel of the sessions to just lead the way for that. And there's a couple times where we cut a song that inspired like another song that I wasn't even planning on cutting.
Yeah.
We had to sit down and play, like, what about this one? Like, track record.
Okay.
So is that it, over and over?
Over and over.
C, A minor, F? We had kind of a acoustic type chill vibe, and it's like, what other songs you got, you know, that you just, we could just try. And that day worked out really nice.
Track record is a Love Junkies song. It didn't sound like that on the work tape. It was just Hillary playing, I think. But that's the song that I feel like is pretty honest. It's like pretty vulnerable. I mean, we all have one, you know, a track record. Checkered past.
What is the checkered board line? I remember, I love that line.
It's a dynamic checkered board.
No. On Main Street. Yeah, I love that one.
I really love what became of it because it was a sleeper for a little while for me. And now it's one of my favorites. My Fleetwood Mac obsession lately kind of came through a little bit on that song.
I have a decent house, but I had these chickens and they had eaten every stitch of grass in the yard. I'm like cleaning up, blowing leaves and picking up plastic and stuff. And I'm just like, I just can't keep my white trash off the lawn.
It's basically an autobiographical song of all of us. I'm just kidding.
It's so me. The lyrics are 100% me. I mean, it says steak fingers in it. I don't know how much more Texas you can get.
I can't keep my roots from showing, but I'm still dishwater blonde. I can't keep my white trash off the lawn.
White Trash was, like, maybe the hardest one.
Yeah.
For some reason. I don't really know why, because I love that song.
I mean, we kind of threw it away. We kind of came back and just worked on it a little bit and was like, wow.
But I just know that I need a song called White Trash.
That's my thing.
I can't write that off.
So
that is who I am.
He don't love me like tequila does. Nobody can. He don't give me that border town buzz like tequila does. I mean, there's a lot of little areas on this record to me that were total mistakes. Sometimes directing two people the wrong way and three other people, so they don't even know they're screwing up, and somehow it can work out that way if you do it right. But you know, that's what we look for, is without trying to intentionally do that.
It's just like playing live. That's what we all do. That's what we want to do.
Yeah.
I feel like we just played live and caught it on tape, you know. They don't love me like the key.
Those songs all come out in the wash and way too pretty. I mean, there's some lines in there that if you really sat down and you would go,
yeah.
Well, maybe what, no, it was the truth. It was what came out, it's what fell out, and it's what made the song write itself.
And it's hard to codify what authenticity is, but to me, there is something so real about the way that she approaches songs and also she approaches her own life.
I think it kind of ended up in a place of just owning it, all of it, you know? And I've always been that way in my music. I've never tried to hide anything. Sometimes I've been too honest, uncomfortably honest, but I just believe in it because that's my job, is to just say, here's my story. Hope y'all have one similar.
Count us in there, buddy.
Luke had texted this piece of this poem.
I had an idea of a song that was about keeping a bluebird in your heart. I'd let it somewhere, and I wanted to unfold the idea of what that could be.
So him and Natalie and I got together, and it was one of those songs that, writing it, we all just kind of got our piece in there. The line, "If house keeps on winning, I got wild card up my sleeve," actually was inspired by my tattoo. It's a Queen of Hearts wild card up my sleeve, because sometimes I feel like I've been able to pull the wild card out from under my sleeve in so many situations in my life. And it's kind of a reminder that I'm the queen of my own heart, just to like count on me. And then it ended up being kind of the perfect album title because of everything the record says. And this one just found these pockets of confidence and hope and my roots of country music and rock and roll that kind of blended perfectly together. I've had moments of those on every record I've done, but this one had an overall theme of own the skin you're in. Right now, I feel like I'm excited to see what the future holds, because I love to play music. I love to write music. I love to play music. I love getting on my bus and going to the town and meeting people and hearing them sing songs that mean something to them. And as long as I can do that, I'll be happy.